Here's the takeaway, my friends. The government is not going to keep you safe. The government is putting you in danger. The government is presiding over a collapse in school standards. The government is presiding over and paying for, in many ways, the drugging of very young children with very dangerous drugs. The government has displaced private and personal and voluntary methodologies for keeping people safe, which is keeping tabs on your neighbors, having chats, having good relationships with the police, making sure that everything is followed through. There is this kind of, you know, throw the ball of responsibility over the fence and never follow up, because the government is now perceived to be taking care of communities. Well, the government is not taking care of communities in Sweden. The government is not taking care of communities in South Africa. The government is not taking care of communities and young women in England. The government is not taking care of you. You are, to the government, tax livestock, to be programmed, to be exploited, and to be lied to and bribed into voting for surrendering your own freedoms. Free stuff in return for freedoms. And the free stuff will pass, and the loss of freedoms will be permanent. The government is not your friend. The government is not your pal. The government is not your father. The government is not your husband. The government is not just. It is not fair. The government is force. The government is the only agency able to legally initiate the use of force against usually legally disarmed citizens. The government is coercion. The government is fire. It is a very dangerous servant and an entirely tyrannical master. And as long as the government continues to grow, your safety will continue to shrink.